Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Arms Day. I'm standing on the dead bodies of my enemies for many reasons, one of which is we're doing the field test weapons, another of which is my video file that I recorded this morning corrupted and didn't get any audio, so rather than try to just re-record my voiceover on the video that I didn't really have a good idea on the timing of anything, so I wouldn't be able to sync it up, it'd be a whole lot of, oh, I guess I'm going to look at this thing, and oh, this thing's now. So I just wanted to take a little field trip on this Arms Day. We're going to do a little field test weapons. We're going to shoot some things, and then we're going to take a look at my Foundry orders. Now, I can't go back and re-record the Foundry order picking of the packages. I can go back to the tower and just stand by Banshee and do it, but I figured it'd be more fun just to sit out here, talk about the guns, and look at the ones I picked. And you, if you haven't picked them yet, you can just look at the perks I got. I'll tell you which number package they are, but you don't have to worry about it too much. It's not a big deal. So anyway, guys, this is one of the field test weapons. This is the Hake auto rifle. I think it's the first one. You got to use it on Cabal and kill them. This guy right here doesn't count because he's red bar, so we're going to kill him with a sniper. But all these other guys, other red bar, yellow bar enemies don't count. Red bar enemies do. So let's take a look at the field test weapons. You can do most of them right here. Where I am in the Hollows. It's a good place to do anything Cabal related. So, the field test weapons, there's four primaries, one secondary. The four primaries you can do all at once. That's imprecation, don't worry about that one. So we have the Hake Teste auto rifle. You need to get Cabal kills, basically. Just kill Cabal. I think it's 4% per, so that means I've killed six Cabal, so you have to kill 25 total. That's the Hake Teste auto rifle. Then we have the Suros TSA auto rifle. Precision kills. You can do this against Cabal too. So just shoot him in the head. You should only have to do 10 with that. Then we have the Hake Teste hand cannon. This one you need to get double kills. So I would suggest shooting them in the head against. It's only got a 5-round mag. You're going to have trouble with this. If you can't do it here with the Cabal, go to Waking the Hive. Go to the Dark Beyond. And pop the thralls as they're coming at you. And then the last primary is the Hake Teste pulse rifle. This one you have to get precision kills, so it should be only 10. Not a big deal. You can do it against the Cabal right here where I am. That's where I'm going to do all four of these. And then the last one is the Amalon Test RR1 sniper rifle. This is the one you have to kill fallen captains with. What's going on? Like, I didn't make my control stick move up. Apparently my controller is doing something weird. It likes to creep up every once in a while. Now, it started happening yesterday. It's not good. Not good. Will definitely be a problem in trials if it keeps doing it. But this one you have to kill fallen captains, not major captains, just fallen captains. I usually do that in the Cosmodrome in the area that's left. Once you load in on patrol, go left. The next area on top of the hill before you go into Skywatch, there's a captain that spawns there religiously. And then there's another one in the cave below him and another one in the cave over by the airplane. If not there, go to Forgotten Shores. And there's a captain right before you go into Rasputin's bunker that if you kill him, jump down, and then drive back up, he will respawn, and you can kill him over and over again. So those are the field test weapons. They're very easy this week. No crucible ones, so it's not a big deal. This auto rifle I'm not too crazy about. It's got a slow rate of fire, but a really small magazine. It's got crowd control, so that helps it a little bit, but its reload is magnificently slow. Just magnificently slow. Can't stand it. But these field test weapons aren't meant to be amazing. They're meant to be just guns you use to get some rank. So, the Foundry orders. Let's take a look at the Foundry orders. Now, in no particular order, because they all go by order of however you picked them up, so you don't really have any order. So I figured I'd get the Foundry orders, pull them out, and we'll shoot them. So let's start with the Kuma Katok HC4. The one I picked is the number 2 selection. It has Luck in the Chamber, Snapshot, Outlaw, Danger Close, and Rifled Barrel. This is the higher rate of fire mid-impact hand cannon that the gunsmith sells. It's a fun gun, almost. We'll see with these perks. I like the rate of fire. It's really easy to use. It doesn't have a lot of recoil. This is they're all unupgraded right now because I haven't done anything with them. But I like it. It's cool. I don't know if I'll end up using it very much, but it's definitely nice to have. The reload's good. So that's the first gun I picked. Next! We're going to look at the Ufern HC4 hand cannon. This is also the number 2 selection. Comes with Firefly and Army of One with extended mag, oiled frame, and surrounded. I like it. It's the higher impact, slower rate of fire hand cannon from Amalan's Arms Day guns. See if we can get some more kills with it. There's very little recoil though. For as high of an impact as it is, it's low recoil. Reload's a little slower, but it's got a really good recoil pattern. I think it might be that open nose on the front of the gun. I kind of enjoy it. Okay, here's what we're going to do, guys. I'm going to do the rest of the guns this way. We'll talk about them, but I want you to tell me, do you prefer this, or do you like it when I stand at the gunsmith and talk about my selections as I make them? I think I might prefer this better, actually, because you get to see me use all the guns. Next, the Tuonela SR4. I didn't keep it. There wasn't really anything any good that I liked, so I actually deleted that after I recorded the video to get some marks and some weapon parts. And dadgummit, if the video file didn't corrupt. So I don't have that gun to show to you, but it's just like the Hungjury. The one I picked was the number one selection, but they were all kind of not that great. I think it had Rescue Mag and like Army of One on it or something. Nothing that special. There goes my thumbstick again. I don't know what's going on there. So let's move on to the Suros PDX-45, and yes, I got two of them. I got two of them because I had two packages for some reason. I felt like getting two PDX-45s. Right now, it's my favorite gun in the game. This one has Secret Round. This is the number one choice, I think, the one with Secret Round. Now, the recoil pattern on the 45 is pretty good. And, I mean, the fire rate is real good. Now, I don't know what's going to happen with the December patch in a week or two, so it may get real bad. I can't promise you anything. Oh, you jerk. Quickscope. But it's a great gun. It's my favorite pulse rifle right now. 45. The PDX-41 goes right along with it, as do some of the Hake pulse rifles. But I like this one a lot. It's my favorite. I got the one with Secret Round. This was the number two selection. It has Hammer Forged, Appended Magazine, Secret Round, Lightweight, and Hand-Laid Stock. Now, the Hand-Laid Stock is going to reduce your range, but that Hammer Forged will push the range back up. So with the Secret Rounds, the Hammer Forged, and the Hand-Laid Stock, this gun should be amazing. It should be a laser beam. It should be a fun gun. It should be everything you want it to be. Now let's take a look at the other one. This is the number two. This is the first selection, but it would be my number two pick. It has Hidden Hand, Perfect Balance, which that's going to make almost max stability too. Feather Mag, Snapshot, and Rifled Barrel. I would probably go with the top selections. The Perfect Balance, Hidden Hand, and Snapshot. It'd be a very, very quick gun. Very, very quick. Right now it's going to shoot the same as the other one, so I'm not going to equip it and shoot stuff with it. But you get the idea. It will behave just like this one. So either one of those is a good selection. I think the Secret Round one is definitely a better choice. Look at that range. The stability just out the box is amazing. So PDX-45, that's my choice. And last, the Suros DIS-47. I would call this the full auto gift. It's an amazing weapon. I love it. It's my favorite scout rifle, and I think this will become the new gun for trials. These fast firing scout rifles, if you're not using the Mida multi-tool once it comes back. But yeah, just this gun. I'm just pulling the trigger right now. This is not upgraded at all. DIS-47. It's a fast fire rate, low impact scout rifle, but it's a lot of fun and it sounds great. Oh, it sounds great. It comes with Hammer Forge, Feather Mag, full auto, lightweight, and small bore. So that Hammer Forge with small bore is going to push that range out really good. Or you can go with the Feather Mag, which I'm probably going to do because scout rifles don't suffer any range fall off, but it's always good to have range. So either one of these perks right now is really good. That Feather Mag's are basically double your reload, or cut your reload speed in half. So this is my main takeaway from Arms Day, this DIS-47 with full auto. Really excited about it. It's the gun I wanted. Oh gosh, not you guys. Every time I go here to do stuff with Cabal, I end up getting the Taken to spawn and I don't like them. But anyway guys, those are the Foundry orders from last week, my choices that I made. The funnest guns. It was one of the best weeks I've seen on Arms Day, I really think. I know people are kind of not as enchanted with it as they were, but I still really, really like Arms Day, and I think it's a lot of fun. So I'm going to keep putting these videos out. I think I'll do it like this style, just running around shooting stuff and talking about the guns, because it's more fun to me to do it like this rather than, oh, let's sit at the tower and let's analyze the selection. And I think I'm going to do it like this. I'll show you what I got. We're going to shoot it. I'll talk about why I picked it, and I'll tell you which one it is. And then we'll do some field testing. Anyway, guys, I'll tag on the end of this. I'll go back to the tower and show you the Foundry orders for next week. Okay, so for next week, you have the selection between the Hake Arminius D, the Hake Zerania D, the Suros DIS-43, the Amalan Thessen FR4 fusion rifle and the Hake Jingu Kogo D shotgun. So order of operations, probably would go with the Arminius D first, then the scout rifle, the DIS-43. It's a high rate, it's a high impact scout rifle from Suros. Then it's kind of up to you what you want to do next. I like the Zarene. I like the bullet hose auto rifle. It's pretty cool, but the Arminius is the slower fire rate. Zarene is the high fire rate. And then if you're a fan of fusion rifles, get the Thessen FR4. I would pick the shotgun last. I'm not a big fan of that shotgun for whatever reason. It just didn't strike me. So, but that's my order. It may not be yours, so take your pick as you will. But that's what I think. So anyway, guys, that's all I got for you on this Arms Day. Thanks so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video. Subscribe if you want to see more videos. That's how I know you like it. So until next time, guys, thanks for watching. I'm Death from Above, and I will see you later. See you. Bye.